dance on the chains of my circumstance, walk on the waves of the storm. I won't dance on the chains of my circumstance, walk on the waves of the storm. I won't dance on the chains of my circumstance, walk on the waves of the storm. I won't dance on the chains of my circumstance, walk on the waves of the storm. Cause nothing is impossible for those who believe God's love. Oh, nothing is impossible for those who believe that God.
Children, and she, your needs aren't her number one needs anymore, which when you look sad, men can go through. And they're sad, and they say, oh, I don't, you know, I'm married. And it's
so, like, so the industry, like you, Sevi, you're a businesswoman, you're also a counsellor, and you're also, like, you're almost like having to interview terrorists in some sense, because you're aware of the arguments and dodgy punters, that there are men out there that have a passion, anger within, you know, So how do you protect yourself? Like, do you have to be on the ball all the time for that?
You have to be on the ball all the time. You can't go into this industry and half-ass it and think that you're going to look after yourself, because you're probably not going to. It takes so much, it takes a lot of intelligence to be able to switch off an emotional and physical feeling you're in to make that feel like it's not. It takes me a long time to prepare to go for it to work, and it takes me a long time to wind down and come from work. But it takes a lot of people that just to go to their office job anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
Look, Stephanie, you're
it takes two completely independent individual people who are happy with themselves before they can fall in love with each other.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. Can I ask a question?
Yes.
You describe what you do as intimacy?
I beg your pardon?
You describe what you do as intimacy?
Intimacy?
Yeah.
Well, at work or outside of work?
At work.
At work, intimacy is, it's physical, so kissing, sensuality.
No, it's not my question. You describe it as being intimacy, right? My question is, do you find that some of your... You said you don't like to talk to your clients out of work situations. And is that because some of those clients find it hard to separate what they do with you and what real intimacy is?
Yeah, it is. It is, and I often become increasingly uncomfortable when my clients have a fake idea of what our session is about. So if someone starts to show too much sign of affection and they're starting to take it a little bit more personally than what it is, I generally like to cut that person off, because I don't like to feed a fake feeling and romance. I don't want to hustle you into thinking you love me and give me your money. I want to give you a service, and I want you to enjoy 1 hour with me or however long you decide to pay for, without being wrapped up in the extra emotion that is. I think that there is a whole science behind, like, the chemical reaction after you've had sex with somebody, and that you do have feelings. And that's why, as a sex worker, it takes years to learn how to switch off your emotional switch. And that's why when you ask me if I ever fall in love with my clients, I wouldn't and I don't. And it comes down to the fact that most of the time, the kind of people I spend time with at work, I'm spending time with them under my fake identity, which means my interests are probably not 100% real. You know, I grew up in Byron Bay, so as you can imagine, I'm quite a little down-to-earth hippie sort of girl, and my suits and clients aren't really interested in what the moon phase is doing or what kind of crystal I've been charging the night for. So I'm going to talk to them about everyday events. And yeah, if they do become too emotionally involved, they do cut it out, because that's hustling.
Both you and your clients find it hard to separate the feelings from the sex.
I don't find it difficult. I think that if somebody is coming and seeing you once a week because they're lonely, and you then become a support system for them, and you're sharing stories, and you're one thing they look forward to every week, yes, it's easy for someone who is already lonely enough to be coming to a sex worker to fall in love or to think that there's something more going on than there is.
Mm-hmm. Can I just ask, just for the intimacy, a follow-on from the intimacy question, is how do you, and I think I asked it to you in an interview, how do you protect yourself from the men who have this sudden passion of rage, and it may even be something that you haven't identified? Has that been an issue for you? Or do you, like, I feel like I need to teach you.
Because
there's a lot of dodgy
guys
and hunters out there.
I know. I very much know. I have worked for 6 years. I have worked all over Australia. I have worked from private brothels, apartments, Raventar, Cairngirling. I have met the clients.
How do you protect yourself?
Look, there are few and far between many that would become any sort of enraged or... I'm lucky. I call myself a privileged prostitute because I'm not doing it out of survival. I'm doing it out of choice, which means that I work at nice establishments and I pick my clientele rather than someone who's maybe in a different situation and money is needed right there and then. I work in a nice establishment currently and safety is paramount, always paramount. So we have cameras, we can see you before you can see us. If something happens in the room and someone becomes a bit, it might be what you call rage, I might call it overly excited or overly passionate in the moment. It's not hard to shut. If you are really come across as confident and I don't take a lot of shit, it's funny because I always laugh. I'm quite a soft person and I always avoid conflict and I'm, you know, a bit of a pushover in life because I just love everyone. I want everyone to be happy. But the second that door and I shut it and we're in there now, I am always in control.
What's your
course? Recently, it's just to be trying to keep it decriminalised in New South Wales and to get the rest of Australia to follow the same module. Australia, we have it really good, and we know that. New South Wales is very far ahead of their time. I think.
Do you? With any pimps and things like that?
Yeah.
Where do the men factor in the rules? Are there men brothels running them?
There may be men.